Hello everybody, I welcome you to my lecture on function definitions, and our goal today is to build a magic function that will be useful to you in many different scenarios during this class, and to learn also a little bit about global variables. So let's think about something that we always need. Something we will always need is a function that is able to check if two positions on our canvas collide with each other. Let's look at an example. So my wife has written a little Python code in this class, which she calls Astro Powers. I provided the URL for you. Let's show you real quick what this code does. So here it is. If you start it, you see this astronaut and you can move him around. And if you press arrow up, he shoots a laser beam. And as you see, the laser just passed the meteor. If you do it again, you see how this laser beam just passes the meteor and does not do anything to it. So this is the problem that my wife faced, and I tried to explain it to her. And now I'd like to explain to you what you can do in order to model a collision in between the laser beam and the meteor. So what do we need for this? Well, we're gonna make sure that we understand that when we work on the canvas, we deal in positions and width and in height, or in X and Y. So what we actually try to compare are not the pictures we see, like the picture of the laser beam or the picture of the meteor. Rather, we are looking at the X and the Y positions of these pictures. And so what we have to take is first the position of the laser beam and then the position of the meteor. And then we have to check if the two of them are so close to each other that we can consider it a hit or a positive event. And if that stage, if that occurs, then we want to stop the canvas from drawing these images, because then they're not there anymore. So let's make a battle plan how we can go about this. So what does our function need to be able to do? Or what does our function need to work? Well, the first thing this function needs is has to figure out what is the position of the laser. Then second, what is the position of the meteor? And third, we have to give it a threshold that defines if we have a hit or not. And now the question, how do we define a function that works in lots of different cases and just cares about two objects with positions and the threshold that defines a hit? Well, it's pretty straightforward. For this, you just write def to define a function. You give it a useful name, for example, isCollision. And then you open parentheses. And inside of the parentheses, you write all the parameters that you want the function to use. So you can have position A for the position in our case of the laser, and position B for in our case the position of the meteor, and a radius, which is the threshold that defines if we have a positive event or not. And then afterwards you make this colon, and then there's the body of what the function is actually going to do. We discussed that in a bit. So if this is the way how we define a function, how can we call such a function inside of our code? Well, the first thing we have to imagine is, if we want to check if there is a positive event, we have to look a lot of times. Actually, every time when we draw the canvas, we want to find out if the laser beam hits the meteor or not. So the right position to where to put our call to the isCollision function is inside of the draw function that is called by our simple GUI draw handler, which in my case, in the case of this code, is called draw parentheses canvas. And so inside of this text body, we want to call the function isCollision. And what do we pass on? Well, we said we want to pass it the laser position, the meteor position, and a threshold. And now, just to give you another illustration of what it means when you call a function and put these arguments inside of the parentheses. After you call isCollision inside of your code, It will look at the definition of the function with the very same name, and then it will assign the arguments you passed in to the parameters with which the function was defined. So in this case, we defined our isCollision function to take in the argument pos A, pos B, and radius. And so laserPos will be assigned to pos A, meteorPos to pos B, and threshold to radius. And so behind this colon in the indented part of the function, all of these three variables are now filled with the values that were former contained in these three arguments. Okay, after this has been understood, we can start working on the body of this function. And this is somewhat similar to the lecture of this week, but let's talk again about it. What do we have to do if we want to look if two points are so close that we can consider them to be colliding with each other? So if we look at our canvas, it has a height and a width. And if we say, well, we have a position x here and a position x here, where we say, well, this may be the position of our laser and this the position of our meteor, then we want to find out what is the distance in between these two points. And the way we can do that is we can imagine that we draw a straight line in between this point and this point and say, well, the length of this line is the distance in between the two points. And how do we get this length? Well, what we can look at is the difference in the height and the width of these two points. So if we draw a horizontal line from this point to the canvas edge, we get a position in y or in height. And if we do the same for this one, we get this position. And now the difference in between these two positions, the difference in the height, is also this difference here. It's exactly the same length. And you can see that this side forms the side of a triangle. And there's actually another one that's right here, which is just the difference in width, which you get the same way if you just go up towards the width edge of the canvas. So if we take the difference of the width of this point and the width of this point, we get this side of a triangle. And if we take the differences of the heights, we get this side. And now if we have two sides given, we can just simply apply the Pythagorean theorem for rectangle triangles to get the side of the longest line of the hypotenuse. And this works by just saying, well, this side to the square plus this side to the square is equal to this side to the square, or written as a to the square plus b to the square equals c to the square. And now, when do we have a hit, a collision? Well, we say if this distance here, c, is smaller or equal to the radius, then we have a hit. Or in other words, if c is larger than the radius, then we want our function to say false, there's no hit, return false. In every other case, this point would be inside of this circle. We want to say, oh, it's a collision. We want to say true. Okay. So my question to you is now to please stop this video and try to build a function that exactly puts these math concepts into action. You have the URL provided for you. Just try to write the function, call it from the draw handler, and see if you can make the fireball, the laser beam, and the meteor hit each other or not. Okay, you're done. Well, then compare it with the function that I wrote. The way I would set it up is I'd say define isCollision. I would give it the parameters we discussed and then just say, well, return whatever the square root of the x position of pos A minus the x position of pos B to the square is plus the y position of pos A minus the y position of pos B to the square. So this is the same as saying a to the square plus b to the square equals c to the square, and taking the square root on both sides, ending up with square root of a to the square plus b to the square, and then looking if this result is smaller than the radius. If it is smaller than the radius, so if c is smaller than the radius, then we were inside of the circle and we want to return a hit. So then it will return true. In every other case, it will return false, and it's not a hit. Okay, so after you define such a function, how can we use it? Well, let's look at this code. Here's this function, defIsCollision, and we make it return a Boolean. This here is an evaluation with a smaller sign, smaller radius sign. So this will return either true or false. And so what we do is inside of our drawCanvas function, down here where it says there is a meteor, we say if isCollision, which asks does my meteor collide with my laser? If so, then I do not want to have a laser around anymore, and I do not want to have a meteor around anymore. Well, if you're now wondering what all these words here are, I expected you to have looked at the code and tried to understand the names, the values that are contained inside of these parameters. And if you haven't done this, or if this is confusing to you, let me explain to you again what's going on. So at the top of this code, my wife defined a few global variables, and here are, for example, the y and the x position of the laser and the y and x position of the meteor, defined as global variables. And other global variables are, is laser there or is meteor there? And these two are important game status parameters that have an impact on what is drawn on the canvas and what not. So inside of our draw canvas, we check if there is a laser. And only if there is a laser, we're going to draw the picture of the laser. Don't worry about this draw function. This is very similar to just drawing a circle. We just decided we want to have a cooler picture. So we just load it in a picture and say, draw this picture. Don't worry about this stuff here. Important is just that over here, this tuple contains the position of the laser. And my wife didn't like lists at that point, so we have x and y positions as separate parameters. And the same is going on for the meteor. Only if a meteor is there, it will be drawn with the x position and the y position. And every time after it's drawn, it will be updated, the same with the laser, so that the meteor falls down and the laser flies up. Now, inside of this text body, we want to make sure that we update the global variables to change the state of the game so that in the case of a collision, neither the laser nor the meteor will any longer be displayed. In order to do that, we just call our function isCollision, and this function returns true or false. If it returns a true, then this part of the code will be executed. And all it does, it says if there is equal to false, that means this part will not any longer be displayed, so we won't see the picture of the laser beam anymore. And the second one sets the isMeteor variable to false, so that the meteor is not drawn anymore, and we also do not check anymore for collisions. Okay, so let's see this in action. Now I see this meteor dropping down, and if I go under it and press the arrow key up, it should hit it and both vanish, and a new meteor shows up. So we can go over there and shoot at it. And so you have a little game and you see how you can check if two objects hit each other or not. I hope you enjoyed this little presentation, and this may help you to understand the principles of defining functions with parameters and calling them a little bit better. Thank you and have a good week.